other thing that I had, and I'm not going to demonstrate it because you guys don't need to watch me boil water and put a tea bag in there. So I went ahead and made it. But one thing I, two things I want to say is I did use the Splenda to sweeten it, and I do have a sample for you to try it. And it's the green tea, which is also healthy for you. It has a lot of antioxidants in it. I did use, and now with when you and whenever you see those reports like that, that green tea has more antioxidants, they always come out with the green tea, and then they have the green tea with orange, then they have the green tea with berry, then they have the green tea with pomegranate, then they have the, so there's all sorts of different flavors. I use the green tea and berry, which is very good. It's a little bit different in an iced tea. You could do this in a, if you wanted to have a different kind of taste, mix it with a little bit of, once you make the tea, and it's just making tea, mix it with a little pomegranate juice, you know, that POM, pomegranate, that juice that we have in the produce department. It's very good. I believe it also comes in pomegranate blueberry, which is another oxidant type food for you to, that's good for you. You could put a little of that juice in there. Again, I would watch the sugar content. This has no calories, this has no sugars because we use the Splenda. When you start adding juices and things, you have to sort of take it into your own dietary thing, whether you're using natural sugar or whether you're using artificial, and remember that corn syrup and fructose and all those other toast things are all sugar. So, you know, I if you're going to use sugar. Don't use the corn syrup and stuff like that. Seems like that's what we're getting more used to. So just final thought is to just keep it more natural, less processing. The less processing, the better it is for you. You can see that we didn't do anything that was very difficult here. Everything was relatively easy, and everything was healthy.